She walks in beauty like the night of cloudless climes and starry skies, and all that's best of dark and bright meet in her aspect and her eyes. Thus mellowed to that tender light which heaven to gaudy day denies. One shade more, one ray less, had half impaired the nameless grace which waves in every raven dress, or softly lightens o'er her face. Where thoughts serenely sweet express how pure, how dear their dwelling place. And on that cheek and o'er that brow, so soft, so calm, yet eloquent, the smiles that win, the tints that glow, but tell of days in goodness spent, a mind at peace with all below, a heart whose love is innocent.
This is a famous poem by Lord Byron. The object of his description is a woman. People say he met this woman, mysterious woman, in the party, and he wrote this poem on her. It is just 3 stanzas, and still poet describes a new view to see the beauty. She walks in beauty. Well, generally we describe beautiful women as she is beautiful, not as she walks in beauty. But here, this phrase, which is also the title of the poem, is unique because it shows movement, not just a steady still picture kind of beauty. It means that when she walks gracefully, and that looks beautiful. So she walks in beauty. But then he says, like the night of cloudless climes and starry skies. Well, that is something new, because beautiful is always associated with white. But here he's saying that beautiful, but like a night. So night is dark. So how dark is beautiful here? Well, he's saying that a night of cloudless climes and starry skies. The black sky and little dots of millions of stars in it, white, bright, tiny. It really looks beautiful. Well, that kind of beauty she's carrying with her. And all that's best of dark and bright meet in her aspect and her eyes. Now, eyes are a general object of beauty, but here he is describing them as all that is best of dark and bright. So whatever dark and light represent, whatever, however they can be beautiful, the best of them meets in her aspects and in her eyes. Let's imagine if we had just bright eyes, like white eye and lighter yellow tone of pupil. How it would look. But we have white eye and then a darker color of pupil, so dark and bright both mingles there and creates beautiful. So Byron is saying that beauty is about combination of dark and bright. It is neither just one, it is both. Thus mellowed to that tender light which heaven to gaudy day denies. Yes, daylight, sunlight, it is beautiful, but night has its own charm. Daylight doesn't allow us to see the beauty of space, stars, moon, asteroids. It can only be seen in the night. So he's saying that what daylight denies us, only nightlight can allow us. So beautiful, so beauty is here. One shade the more, one ray the less, had half impaired the nameless grace. Well, there is nothing like perfection in beauty. But here Byron, being a romantic poet, is talking about a kind of perfection in beauty, that he is saying that even we add one more shade, or we delete one ray from it, one ray of brightness, the beauty she is having will not remain the same. Whatever combination it is perfect. So it will kind of makes a beauty ultimate combination of light and dark, which waves in every raven tress, or softly lighten over her face. And that perfection is glowing all over the world and over her face. That is kind of thing it is. And also the word nameless grace, that perfection is so undefined that it is nameless. That kind of beauty she is having. Where thoughts suddenly sweet express how pure, how dear that dwelling place. Where the woman's face has this sweet expression, which is suddenly sweet. Yes, beautiful, dark, everything, but still it is sweet. So it shows, Byron says, that it mirrors the thought of the woman, that she is also thinking sweetly. So her exterior is beautiful, but also the interior, her mind, is similarly beautiful. How pure and how dear the dwelling place. Now, dear here is not dear or darling, but it is precious or important. And on that cheek, and over that brow, so soft, so calm, yet eloquent, the smiles that win, the tints that glow, but tell of days in goodness spent. Now we come to a territory where poet is not going with the convention that generally describing the beauty of a woman than the poet narrator some most of time sees her as a sexual object, but here it is not happening. Here Byron is doing something else. Well, he is now describing her smile, and that smile makes her face animate with cheek bulging and all that. So it is so soft and calm. It is very much calm that he is saying that it tells of the good deeds she has done in the past days. So the beauty she is having, maybe it is not the physical beauty only, but it is the manifestation of her good deeds, being a good, beautiful human being. She has done good and helping deeds, and that is why she is so beautiful. A mind at peace with all below, a heart whose love is innocent. The exterior is now forgotten. Now it is all about interior, mind, heart. So mind is at peace, and the heart is innocent, and the love that comes from there, that heart, is also innocent. It is not sexually charged or erotic, but innocent, lovely, and calm. Thank you.